These are the skulls of Pachycephalosaurus, Stygimoloch, and Dracorex. All three are members of the dome-headed dinosaur group called Pachycephalosaurid. They lived alongside one another in the late Cretaceous period of western United States. Remains have been unearthed from the Lance Formation and the famous Hell Creek Formation. Just like many other dinosaurs from this area, the three also had elaborate head ornaments. Although seemingly different, recent hypothesis suggests that they are not separate taxa, but growth stages of the same species of animal. Dracorex is the juvenile form, and Stygimoloch is the sub-adult form of Pachycephalosaurus. But how can they have such different head shapes? Why were they given different names? Are they really the same species? Since the beginning of its discovery, the Pachycephalosaurus has always been confused as other animals. The first fossil attributable to Pachycephalosaurus was found in 1859, but it wasn't until 1943 that the name Pachycephalosaurus was established as a genus. It was instead first described in 1872 as a type of armored, armadillo-like reptile named Tylosteus. In 1892, a Pachycephalosaur skull fragment was mistakenly described as the dermal armor of Triceratops. The next year, it was re-examined and was more accurately described as a dome-headed dinosaur and a new genus, Stygimoloch, was established. In 1931, Charles Gilmore described a new dome-headed dinosaur and named it Troodon wyomingensis. At this point, the genus Pachycephalosaurus has not yet been established, and the family for Pachycephalosaurids was known as Troodon today. Troodon was only known from tooth fossils at that time, and since its teeth are similar to those of Stegoceras, Troodon was thought to be a dome-headed dinosaur similar to Stegoceras, hence the mixed naming. It was in 1945 that this misconception was properly resolved. Dome-headed dinosaurs were assigned as Pachycephalosaurids, and Troodon refers to a type of small, meat-eating theropod dinosaur. Prior to this, in 1943, with newer, more complete materials, two species of dome-headed dinosaurs were already named Pachycephalosaurus, P. Granger and P. Reinheimeri. The Troodon wyomingensis from the 1931 description was also appropriately renamed as Pachycephalosaurus wyomingensis. But 40 years later, these three species were all merged into the type species P. wyomingensis. They were all considered synonymous. Then in 1988, a new genus, Stanophilus, was described based on a new specimen. But this name is rather dubious and is commonly considered as synonymous with the Stygimoloch. In 2006, a near-complete skull was discovered and was determined to be a new species, extravagantly named Dracorex hogwartsia, in reference to the dragon from Harry Potter. A different taxonomic review also reassigned the first Pachycephalosaurus fossil, once referred to as Tylosteus, to be within the genus Dracorex. Supporting the coexistence of three genera of Pachycephalosaurid in late Cretaceous North America, each with only a single species, Stygimoloch spinifer, Pachycephalosaurus wyomingensis, and finally, Dracorex hogwartsia. All with unique head ornaments. Pachycephalosaurus was the largest, with the most pronounced dome. Stygimoloch had the largest spikes, but a smaller dome. And Dracorex, the smallest of the three, with just spikes and a flat head with thickened roof. But 3 years later, again, the validity of these genera was challenged. Evidence presented in a 2009 study determined that the cranial characters did not represent separate taxa, but were actually ontogenetically derived features, the developmental stages of a single taxon. The three names were synonymized, and Dracorex and Stygimoloch were designated as juvenile and sub-adult forms of Pachycephalosaurus. The study revealed that the skull bones of the Stygimoloch specimen were less dense and highly vascularized, indicative of an actively growing pace. A fully formed dome, referable to Pachycephalosaurus, has a comparatively less vascularization, meaning growth has subsided. This growth pattern shows that juvenile Pachycephalosaurus lost spikes and grew domes as they aged. The discovery of the youngest individual of Pachycephalosaurus specimen known today further supported this hypothesis. Its morphology matched the growth curve presented in the 2009 study projected backwards, confirming that Pachycephalosaurus' skull bones exhibit extreme plasticity and undergo extreme cranial morphological changes during the animal's growth into adulthood. Similar ontogenetic pattern has also been found in another genus. The flat-headed Pachycephalosaurid, Ornithothallus, has been determined to be the juvenile form of the dome-headed Stegoceras. Many other dinosaurs also undergo dramatic cranial ontogeny, most prominently within the ceratopsids and hadrosaurids group. Further evidence can be found from wound marks in the animal's skulls. Although the dome function is still highly debated, a common hypothesis argues that Pachycephalosaurus used the dome for headbutting. Substantial impact wounds and lesions have been discovered in various Pachycephalosaur skulls. A specimen has been observed to endure 23 lesions in its frontal dome. A structural analysis shows that Pachycephalosaur skulls had bone structures comparable to those of bighorn sheep. A histological examination also reveals that Pachycephalosaur domes contain fibroblasts that are capable of healing bones. However, head-on ramming is still difficult to justify. The arrangement of the vertebrae and the shape of the dome itself were unfit to sustain and distribute the stress from the violent impacts. Alternatively, after intimidation displays failed, they might have engaged in flank butting, standing parallel to their rifle during combat and striking each other from the side, suggesting that apart from being a display structure, the domes were used to engage in intra-specific combats. Such agonistic behavior is reserved to adults, specifically adult males. And flat-headed specimens, like the ones referred as Dracorex, lack these damages in their skulls, suitable with their designation as juvenile individuals. The absence of pathologies was also observed in the skull remains of other flat-headed Pachycephalosaurids, such as goiocephaly and homolocephaly, which directly suggests that they also didn't engage in ramming behavior. Thus, it can be inferred that they, and possibly all other flat-headed taxa, are also the juvenile forms of dome-headed adults, though we can never be sure until more materials are discovered and studied comprehensively. Pachycephalosaurus has had many names since its remains were first unearthed. Its unique ontogeny added even more names to its already huge library of aliases. But fossil evidence shows that Dracorex and Stygimoloch are synonymous to Pachycephalosaurus. Juvenile taxonomic separation like this is notoriously difficult to resolve. Probably the most well-known case is the dispute over the designation of a juvenile T-Rex specimen as a different species, the Nanotyrannus. Luckily for Pachycephalosaurus, evidence is quite clear, and so it's safe to say that the Dragon King and the Styx River Demon are nothing more than just young Pachycephalosaurus, a testament to the dinosaur's incredible growth stages.